If you're interested in visiting Washington, D.C. in March, you're probably wondering what there is to do and how to prepare for the weather. Free Tours by Foot and our expert local guides have some advice in this video to prepare you for a trip to D.C. Our biggest top tip is the difference in visiting from the beginning of the month versus the end. March starts one of the busiest seasons in the city, field trip season and cherry blossoms. If you want to avoid both of these and still reap some of the benefits of off-peak travel, you'll need to come at the beginning of the month. That does mean it's still a little chilly and some things are limited, such as our tour schedule, but you won't be waiting in line behind 1,000 eighth graders to get into a museum. But if you're coming in March, you probably want to take advantage of the holidays, the festivals, and the top things to do that occur during spring break and potentially Easter. The number one reason to come to DC in March is to see the cherry blossoms. If that's high on your list, check out our cherry blossom video, coming up next at the end of this one, or use the link in the description below to get to our blog post. Cherry blossoms are hard to plan for. Sometimes they bloom in early March, sometimes in April. But the Cherry Blossom Festival starts in mid-March regardless. There are street festivals, kite flying, fireworks, and music throughout the city for weeks. It will be crowded, so prepare yourself for that, but we offer a lot of advice on how to make the most of a visit. And we have special cherry blossom tours for the best photo ops. Our secret tip, check out cherry blossoms in other parts of the city than just the tidal basin. Arlington Cemetery is also classified as an arboretum and is breathtakingly moving when in bloom. Washington, D.C. isn't thought of as an Irish city, though our Irish history includes a neighborhood called Swamp Poodle that is fascinating. But we still like to celebrate St. Patrick's Day in style, just like our neighboring cities of Annapolis and Alexandria, with parades, music festivals, and of course, a few pints at an Irish pub. As Women's History Month, March is also a great time to learn more about the women's contributions to local and American history. There are so many ways to do this. We offer specialized women history tours, like a walking tour of the women's military history in Arlington National Cemetery, or a personal favorite, the Wild Women of Georgetown, that includes spies and socialites. Many museums have special exhibits focusing on women's history and art. Or you can visit a women's museum, like the Belmont Paul House, part of the National Women's Party, or the National Museum of Women in the Arts. Since March is the start of peak season, many of the top attractions start to require tickets, or those who need tickets year-round start to book out fast. The Holocaust Memorial Museum requires tickets to enter the permanent exhibit starting in March. And if you want to tour the U.S. Capitol building, you might want to reserve tickets a few months in advance. Or join us on a tour where we reserve the tickets for you. Now, planning for the weather in March is a little tricky. Sometimes it's hot and humid, sometimes we get a foot of snow, and sometimes both of those things happen within days of each other. So you want to prepare for any eventuality when packing for a trip to DC in March. Bring layers, good walking shoes, umbrellas, and flexibility. On average, you're going to see mostly sunny days, and the precipitation is usually going to be rain instead of snow, but it does snow in DC in March. Daytime high temperatures early in the month tend to be mostly in the low 50s, about 11 Celsius, but by the end of the month are more likely to be in the low 60s, 16 to 17 Celsius. Overnight low temperatures early in March tend to be in the low to mid 30s, 0 to 2 Celsius. But at the end of the month, the morning low temperatures are more likely to be in the low 40s, 5 to 6 Celsius. The best way to prepare for a trip to DC in March is to join us. Follow us on social media at Top Things to Do DC, where we share up-to-date information about the going-on, special events, and weather updates for this chaotic season. Our tours run rain, shine, or snow, and we tailor the tour to the weather to take advantage of indoor stops, cover from the rain, or shade from the sun. If you want to know more about visiting DC in March, check out our blog post link below. And if you have any advice from a past visit to DC in March, leave your advice in the comments section below. We have articles and videos all about the various top attractions in DC. So subscribe to our channel here, or visit our website at freetoursbyfoot.com.